Today's foolishness and tinkering is accompanied by Juice of the Oats Oatmeal Stout from Oxus Brewing in Winnipeg. They describe it as an easy-drinking dark ale with the aroma of coffee and chocolate, smooth body, and oats in the mash. Some of you that have been around here for quite some time may remember this really cheap, crappy Bluetooth headset that I got in a mailbag a couple of years ago, maybe. It's horrible. It sounds worse than the worst AM radio on a cheap $2 receiver that you've ever heard. And I'm hoping that the problem is here in the speaker elements and not in the radio part, because I want to modify this and put an actual 3.5 millimeter jack on it, chop these off so that I can use a better pair of earbuds. Now, the microphone is in there, and I don't really want this for telephone use. I'm going to use it with my phone, but I just really want it to listen to podcasts while I'm out walking and stuff like that. So I'm not going to stress about moving the microphone from there onto the connector so that I would have the controls up here and the microphone up here on a standard set of earbuds. I'll stick with that, and I'll stick with the controls down there. I just want to do a nice simple earbudectomy and transplant in a female TRSS 3.5 millimeter jack. And I think I'm going to harvest one off one of these two USB-C to 3.5 millimeter that I got, which are not compatible with modern Samsung phones. I don't know what they're compatible with, but they were super cheap on eBay, and after buying two of them, I've given up on that process. First thing to do, I will just harvest the connector off of this thing, which, as I said, I can't use with any of the phones that I've got. And we'll just see what we got in here for wires. Ooh, that is durable. I like it. Even though it's not usable, it is fairly solid jacketing on there. So we've got four wires. Okay, I'll have to pin those out. So initially, I thought I was just going to chop these two wires off at a reasonable length and join them together like that and solder them onto this. And that would sort of work, I guess. But then it occurred to me there is a seam along here, so I might be able to crack this thing open and do this a little bit more tidy. We shall see. Oh, that's actually spudgering open surprisingly easy. It's not even glued. Did not expect that. So there is a little lipo pouch cell underneath there. There's the USB charging. There's the three little dome push buttons. There is the microphone, an LED. What does that call itself? Capacitor, a couple of resistors, and then a single chip solution for everything. EA4136. Yeah, it does almost everything. There's, is that an inductor? Handful of resistors and capacitors. Are you a big capacitor? Maybe. Not much else on there. A couple of LEDs down there and the microphone. And on the back of the board, we have the left ear out there. And the right there. It's even labeled and everything. Well, that is super duper handy. Now I just have to figure out which end I want to put this thing on, I guess. And oh, it looks like I may have to steal some thin wire from somewhere, because that's not quite long enough to get to both ends. And I also guess I need to figure out which is the commons, but I should be able to just ring that out with a meter, I think. There we go. That was easy. What would have been even easier is to look closer, because they're labeled plus and minus, and the minus is in fact the common one. Yeah, this is going to be even easier than I thought. So I'm using the tiniest soldering tip that I have. Come on. One. Two. This side's going to be a little bit more careful, because I don't want to cause problems with those battery cables. Okay, that's pretty straightforward. In order to wire it up, I figured I'd better check what the pinout is, because I can never remember, and then I discovered why I can never remember. There's more than one frickin' standard. And depending on what standard the thing is wired for, either the ground is there and the microphone there, or the microphone there and the ground there. Which sent me down a rabbit hole for a while, and I discovered why there are two different formats. It's another one of those incompatible standards between North America and the rest of the world. So the older standard is the one which is non-North American in origins, and it was used on some older Nokias and some older Samsungs and some older Sony Ericsson stuff. But then along came these guys who hate to use established standards, and they decided that they would put the ground and the microphone on different pins. So rather than fight against them, it looks like the rest of the world adopted to what they do. So the tip is left, which it always has been. The ring is right, which it always has been. The second ring is ground on most modern devices. And the sleeve, this bit back here, is the microphone. I guess there is the standard that we're looking for. So, after all that rabbit holeage, back to my project. So now then, to figure this guy out, which wire is which. So the white wire is left. The red wire is right. The common wire is like gray or green or something, and the microphone is black. So now that I know that, I am not going to use the microphone, so I'll just choppy it off. And actually, I only need to extend one wire, because I can pick the common and the left up from that side, so I just need to extend the right wire over to there. I'll do that with a little bit of red wire out of my little assortment kit here. Red? Yeah, red. Cut off way too much. Nice quick little solder join there. I think this is going to end up nice. I hope. I don't always do neat work, but sometimes I like to try. I'll even put a bit of heat shrink on it just for style points. That helping hands wasn't really doing it for me, so I've just gone to some blue tack here. Hopefully this will do the job. Okay, that and that's in. I don't know whether you can see that around my hand or not. So then I'll run this guy down here and snip him off only slightly too long and get that prepped for soldering. Oh, that might even work. So I think now I just have to deal with the fiddliness of getting everything back into the case. And let's see now, that kind of goes there, the USB goes there. Well, that looks almost reasonable. Is this, now this is going to be thicker than the original wires, so that could cause me a little bit of grief. I'll start from the other end where there isn't much modification. Oh, okay, so that's kind of working. But yeah, I think I have to shave just a little bit off that. Shave, or maybe use a round file just to make a nice, neat hole. I don't want to take too much off because I do want this to have some strain relief properties. I think I'll do a little bit on this side too. I guess if I go too far, I could always get out the hot melt, but don't want to have to do that. There, that's pretty good. I think that works nicely. I don't need any glue or anything. I don't think the original snap fit pins just work. So now I guess the only thing to do is to see if it actually works. So push and hold the power button, watch for the blue lights down here. Yeah, there's a connecting noise. I'm going to hold one of the earbuds up close to the microphone here, and I'm going to start a podcast.
Hey everyone, you're listening to the Simple Electronics Podcast. I'm your host, Dan, from the Simple Electronics YouTube channel, and today's episode is sponsored...
Well, that's excellent. And that sounds so much better than these. The only redeeming feature of these is that they magneted together when you're not using them. That's literally it. And this is much better in every way. I can just drop it into my pocket when I'm out walking the dog or whatever. And yeah, and I guess if I need to use the microphone, I can just hold that up close to my face. I think that's a win. Well, thanks everybody for tuning in and seeing what I'm up to. I appreciate that. Questions and comments down below in the comment section as usual. And once again, thanks for watching. I will talk to you later.